everybody. So I won a store championship recently, and I wanted to give you my updated Musketeers deck that I won the store champion with. Big shout out to Waterford Comics for hosting the store championship. It was a really, really fun day. Even more fun because I won, obviously. I was trying for so long to just win one, and finally it happened. So for all of the bigger events is probably what I will be playing. I just wanted to give you the updated version. So it's just slightly different to my last Musketeers list, but not by very much. You asked for it, so here it is. For our eggs, I am playing the 4 Demimera and the 1 Tsunamon. So you've got your draw and trash, and you've got your when you trash a card, draw a card. They work well together, and I just really wanted to use my Tsunamon alt art. Into our rookies, I am playing 4 Impmon. This Impmon is fantastic because it basically allows you to have 8 Beelstarmons or 8 Gundramons, because you can recycle the back out of the trash, which is lovely. I'm playing 4 Soundbirdmon because you want to trash your option cards anyway to make your Beelstar super cheap. Also, he's a rookie and a bit of draw power. I'm playing 4 Labramon on play, draw, trash. Again, you're trying to fill up your trash anyway, and he's rookie, so he gets some extra draw power as well. Similar to Soundbirdmon. Then I'm playing 2 Gazimon, specifically for the memory boosts. So this tech is good. So for when people are using their memory boost or trying to, they can't with this guy on board. And finally, for the rookies, I'm playing 1 Tapirmon, not only because he's super cute, but also because on deletion, draw a card. You want to draw your cards. You want to trash your cards as much as possible. And he is good for doing that. Best boy. For the level 4 champions, first off, we have 4 of the Deputymon. Arguably the most important champion in the deck. So on play, you get to add a Musketeers and an option card to your hand, but also you can digivolve your Musketeers on top of Deputymon, which is very cool for a cost of 6 rather than having to pay their full cost, especially with Gundramon, because he actually does have digivolution effects. Not so much with Beelstarmon. You wouldn't usually digivolve Beelstarmon on top of a Deputymon unless you were desperate. For some blockers, I'm playing 2 Vilemon. Standard big blocker. I prefer him over the other purple blocker, the Devimon, because of the 6000 DP. I'm also playing 2 Mechanorimon. I love this blocker. He's probably my favorite blocker in Digimon, just because he gets to restand if he kills the Digimon, which is just, it's just such a cool card. He can't attack himself, but he never needs to. Then for our Megas, we are playing 4 of the Beelstarmon. She is the most important card in the entire deck. We actually don't play any level 5s because you don't really need them. You can if you want, but this is just how my deck works for me. I find that it's very consistent and I really enjoy playing it this way. Beelstarmon, the most important card in the deck, hands down. Not only is she super cute, but also she's super powerful. So obviously for every 3 Musketeer card or every option card with a cost of 7 in your trash, her on-play cost is reduced. That's insane. So you can actually technically get her for free. Let me say that again. You can play Beelstar for free. Then you get to add your option card back from your trash and just play it for free. So she's just such a strong card, and you will never not play this at 4. Never. The second best card in the deck is we play 4 of is Gundramon. Again, his digivolution effect is great, where you can reveal the top 5 cards and you get to play a option card from that. He's really good digivolving on top of your Deputymon, and also he's a big ass blocker. He is a thick boy.
Damn boy, he's thick.
That's all you want sometimes. On to our level 7s. So we're playing 2 Omnimon Zwarts. This card is fantastic in this deck because obviously you can digivolve on top of black or purple. So you have your Gundramons or your Beelstar. Now, I'm not playing Magna Kidmon. I don't find him that good for me. And I know some people do play Beelzemon as well. Not for me, but test it out. See what you think of it and let me know if you like that type of playstyle instead. Omnimon Zwart though is fantastic because you get to build up your trash again for your next Beelstar. And then you can play a black, you can play up to 2 black or purple Digimon with a play cost less than 8 from your trash. So you can bring back your blockers or bring back your rookies or play the Deputymon and get his effect all over again. And then if those two effects weren't good enough, you also, when you're attacking, get to return level 6 from this Digivolution line. So you return your Beelstar back to your hand. Amazing. And then you get to just Trump Sword one of your opponent's Digimon with a play cost of 12 or less. Like, insane. Then I am playing 2 Omnimon Zwart Defeat. Now, This card is also another fantastic card. Loving the Omnimons in this deck because not only does it come out in your security, but if you do actually Digivolve into them, you're deleting your opponent's Tamers. And now because of Bond of Friendship and Bond of Courage, their Tamers are super important, which means it's super important for you to kill them. Easy peasy, right? My last Omnimon is Omnimon Alter S. Also goes quite well with this deck. So he's basically a Nidhogg. He digivolves one dude, and also you can make him unblockable, but that's not the important part. The important part is you also get to add back your level 6 underneath this, so you can add your Gundramon back because it doesn't digivolve on top of BEL Star because it's only black or red, but you still get to add your Gundramon back and do all those shenanigans all over again as well. Then the last of my level 7s, I'm playing one Millenniumon. It's just a bit of a tech card. I like playing him in the deck. Being able to return one of your opponent's Digimons is very cool, but also when he dies, if he has Digivolution Sources underneath him, you just get to bring him back, which is also a very cool feature. So just a little bit of tech, bit of board presence, and he's got a thick Bahuki. Now we're going on to the option cards next. The first of my option cards is 4 Flybullet. You get to delete a level 6 or lower Digimon. It doesn't matter if it's suspended or unsuspended, which makes it a little bit better than Trump Sword. Which is why I played this at 4. And also, if it's in your security, you just get to activate the main effect, which is just like a little security bomb. Then I'm playing 3 Trump Sword. Again, the Fly Bullet is better than the Trump Sword, but you can't sleep on Trump Sword either because it goes off in security and it can just straight up delete a big Digimon, which sometimes they can be hard to get rid of. So you're really controlling the board quite a lot with this deck. I'm playing 2 Nailbone, just, you know, so you can get some more board presence, bring out some more blockers, bring out some more rookies, and just fill up your board a little bit more for when you are attacking and going for game. Then we have 2 Geltrummer, the all Digimon with a play cost of 7 or less. That's a pretty damn good card. I only played it 2 because it does affect your own Digimon as well, but that's okay. Card's still good. And adds to hand insecurity, which is good because you're not blowing up your own board, but you're just looking for more security bombs, so he's good at 2. And then finally, I am playing Happy Bullet Shower. So I might not be playing Magna Kidmon, but I am playing his option card. So this is just delete all Digimon with the lowest DP. If there's only one Digimon on board, you're going to be able to delete that, even if it's a really big dude. But the card is just really good, and it goes off in security as well, which is lovely. So I think the main difference between this deck and the previous deck profile is the Mechanoriumon. I did add him in. I find him really good, especially against like Rookie Rich decks. Yep, so I was able to win my store championship with this. Thanks again to Waterford Comics for hosting the store championship. I hope you will have some more and some locals. And I will see you all next time.